Hello friends, in today's session we are going to discuss on a topic advanced instrument, that is a total station. Myself Bipin Patil, assistant professor department of civil engineering, Walchand institute of technology, Solapur. These are the learning outcomes for today's session. At the end of this particular session, learners will be able to explain about total station. What do you mean by total station? Why we are using this total station? What are the purposes, advantages, each and all things we are going to discuss in this particular video session. Total station. Observe this picture very carefully. Display is present here now. Reflector or prism is present. Hand grip is present here for handling this particular instrument. EDM. LED for reflection measurement. Battery. We have provided battery here. Data upload and download through this particular cable, it is present here now. Then pentax, reflector, prism, different types of prism, the reflector, each and all things are present. So what is the purpose to using this particular total station? A total station and the function of this particular total station is very similar to the theodolite, to measure the angles by using electronic distance meter. Then similarly, we are using the same instrument for measuring the distances, maybe horizontal, vertical distances, and to record this particular data directly in this particular instrument. Then the basic principle of total station, basically three principles are present. This is nothing but your geodimeter, that is your instrument. Transmit the rates, reflector is present here, that is nothing but your object, and reflected beam. So get the output data in this particular instrument here, input, output. So three basic principles are present here. These instruments are measuring the distances of a prism poles, that is nothing but the reflector, with the help of laser beam or infrared rays, passed infrared rays. Object is present here, it impacted over the object and get it the output data. These signals are emitted by the instrument, that is nothing but electronic distance meter, and reflected back to the instruments by a prism mounted on the prism poles. And third one, the time interval between emission and reception. It helps to calculate the speed of these particular signals. So how to calculate it? D, that is the distance, T by 2 into V, that is total time taken, and V is nothing but the velocity is there. Refer this figure and get it the idea regarding this. Next one, features of total station. Why we are using this particular? What are the features are present? First one, total station is used for different surveying work. It is most accurate and user-friendly equipment. Easily you can identify the input-output data and easily you can record the data. It gives the position of a point in all direction, that is nothing but X, Y and Z direction, that is nothing but your base points. It measures angles, distances. It displays the coordinates X, Y and Z. EDM is fitted inside the telescope. So telescope is present here and the display is present here, that is nothing but the digital displays there. Then onboard memory to store data. Each and all data is stored here inside this particular instrument. Memory card or other modems are present inside that. Compatibility with computers. Easily you can shrink this data by using computers. Atto level compensator is also available inside this instrument and can work in a lesser visibility. To measure distances even without prismatic targets, For lesser distances, it is possible by using total station. It is waterproof instrument, and different softwares are available. Onboard softwares are available inside the instrument. It is also used to prepare a core layout after feeding data. Use of this particular total station. General purpose of this particular total station is, these are the thing but your instrument, reflectors, cables, prism poles, prism tripod, your instrument is present here. General purpose is to measure the angle, measurement of angle. It may be horizontal angle, it may be vertical angle. Then to measure the distances, horizontal distances, vertical distances. Whenever the major work is there, that is nothing but airport work, railways, highway, canals. So we are using this total station nowadays. Layout of your buildings, it's quite better as compared to remaining instruments. To measure a slope measurement. Slope measurement means in railway work, we are providing a gentle slope. Similarly, we are providing for highway work, slope is present. Canal work, to provide a slope according to the gravitational force, we are providing the water to the crops and remaining purpose. So total stations we are using. Provision of a control surveys. Easily you can control the survey work. Different provisions are present inside this particular instrument. To prepare a contour map, we are using total station. Easily you can achieve the contour map. So it may be your block contouring work, it may be your radial contouring work. So easily you can occupy this particular instrument you are using to prepare a contours and detail mapping of this particular. Next one, setting out and a construction work. So to prepare a layout for your building, for it may be industrial building, it may be commercial building. So for setting out, we are using total station. Similarly, for construction work, any type of construction, it may be residential, industrial, commercial, government project, multitasking projects are there, we are using total station nowadays. Angular accuracy up to 1, here you just consider it may be seconds. Another one function is present or used, that is the distance measured with laser up to near about 2 km, easily can identify the distances. Distance measured with infrared rays up to 4 km with single prism. If I using single prism, so up to 4 km easily can measure this particular distances. Component of a total station. Basic components, just like similar to your theodolite. Tripods, foot screws are present. Instead of this particular horizontal vertical disc, display is present here. Prism, rates, so EDM, that is electronic distance meter, electronic theodolite is present. Then onboard microprocessor we have provided inside this. To collect the data collector is there. To store the input data, output data storage system is provided inside this, and prisms are there. So by using these particular components, easily can achieve distances, angles, and any other work. Advantages of total station. Nowadays, traditional survey methods are laborious and to consume labors, and for speedy work, we are using total station. Traditional survey methods are laborious and time consuming, we are using total station. This instrument is fully automatic. Electronic measurements are there. There is no need to use tape, chain, and either other all things. Another one thing, a digital display we have provided here. So by using this digital display, easily can identify the readings. But in previous unconventional method, you just observe to measure the angles on horizontal disk, on A frame, on B frame, then you just identify the tolerance. So now here directly we identify the readings. Stop readings, distances, angles, each and all things are available here on a display. One more major factor, that is the data storage in instrument is possible. and same data you just store in your computer by using LAN cables. Two more advantages: direct transport to a personal computer of a data stored in instruments. So whatever the data is present here, contour maps are there, contour readings are there, horizontal distances are there, number of project works are present, easily can shrink this data. Online operation through a integrated interface of a computer is possible in a total station. And these are the few disadvantages are there. That is, total stations are dependent on batteries and electronics. Might be some errors are present if battery is discharged, so some problems are happen. The LCD screens does not work well when it is cold. Cold climate is present, so this particular screen is not working properly. Battery life is also short, so this is one type of disadvantage is there. Batteries and electronics both do not work when wet condition is present there. And loss of data is an important consideration is there. Suppose if data is lost, so each and all things are over. These are the major disadvantages are there. Now, my dear friends, you just try to pause the video and give the answer of this particular question. So this is the particular answer of the question. To prepare this particular session, I refer, these are the references. Thank you.